We're going to be focused on jobs, economic vitality, and bringing Philadelphia back from this economic crisis.
We're working every day to make this a safer city.
Here in Philadelphia, we know how to get things done. We are sick and tired of being sick and tired about blight and deteriorated properties in this city.
Next to me. Okay. Where is Councilman Kenney?
Councilman Kenney is right here.
Jim?
Where's my dog?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Good afternoon, and thank you all for coming to this call of unity. Appreciate everyone adjusting their schedules and responding so quickly to the call. I'm joined here today by obviously a large segment of the religious community, communities of faith here in the city of Philadelphia, William Penn's city, founded on the fundamental principles of religious tolerance. There'll be a number of speakers this afternoon. But joined next to me is Imam Muhammad Shahat, the leader of the Al-Aqsa Mosque. I've been with the Imam on many, many occasions at the mosque. We all know of the terrible, thoughtless, ignorant act that someone perpetrated in the city yesterday to somehow try to desecrate the mosque and its peaceful people. That, of course, will not be tolerated here in the city of brotherly love and sisterly affection, the city of Philadelphia. Police Commissioner Ramsey will be up in a second to talk about actions taken by the Philadelphia Police Department. We'll hear from the Imam and other leaders. In addition, there may also be comments that I will make and others will make. I will be speaking later. With regard to some of the commentary and the senseless and thoughtless words of some in the political environment seeking to gain favor, cause division, insult our many Muslim brothers and sisters, but I would suggest it's an insult to all freedom-loving, God-fearing Americans and our international community and brothers and sisters. I will have more to say about that later. First, Police Commissioner Charles Ramsey.
Good afternoon, and thank you, Mayor. Just for your information, obviously we've had for a period of time now special attention being paid to mosques around the city in light of last night. We've stepped that up, and I've asked the supervisors in each of our police service areas to make personal contact with the imam at a particular mosque to make sure that they know if they have any problems, will immediately contact us, give them the appropriate phone numbers to call, 911 being one, but obviously if they want to have another conversation, that district phone number, so they can speak directly with the captain to deal with any particular issues that may come up as a result of someone who, because of the current environment and how everything's being spun up the size, they want to somehow desecrate a mosque or take some kind of other inappropriate action. So we just want them to know that we're there for them. We're going to continue to monitor and make sure that we don't have any incidents occur. And again, encourage anyone who has information about the individuals responsible for the incident that occurred last night, let us know. We do have some video we're trying to enhance to see if we can get a tag number, so the investigation is very active. But we do need the public's help on this, and any assistance at all would be certainly welcome. So. Well, in religious thank you, Mayor. Religious institutions in general, we're paying special attention to, which we have been doing for a period of time. Obviously, after some of the incidents that have occurred around the country, around the world, we have stepped up our presence. This is a holiday season when people are celebrating various religious ceremonies during this period of time, and we want to make sure that everyone, irrespective of their religion, can do so and do so safely. So we've certainly stepped up our presence around all religious institutions.
Thank you, Commissioner Ramsey. And I'll ask Imam Muhammad Shahad.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Salatu wassalamu ala jami'i al-anbiya'i wal-mursaleen. تحية مباركة للحضور وأقدم خالص تحياتي لكل هذه القلوب الطيبة والنفوس الطيبة التي تشعر معنا وتشاركنا في مثل هذا الحدث فتحية مباركة لكم جميعا وخير ما نبدأ به ونستهل به آية من كتاب ربنا الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير صدق الله العظيم أيها الجمع الكريم هذه آية من كتاب ربنا عز وجل وحديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول المسلم من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الناس أنفعهم للناس ونحن جميعا نسيج واحد وجسد واحد ونفس واحدة فأمننا واحد ورخاؤنا واحد واستقرارنا واحد وربنا واحد فنسأل الله عز وجل أن يديم أمننا ورخاءنا واستقرارنا في أمريكا وفي جميع أنحاء العالم وأختتم حديثي بالدعاء للحضور وبالدعاء للناس جميعا اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك السلام فحينا يا ربنا بالسلام وأدخلنا الجنة دار السلام وجزاكم الله خيرا شكرا Thank you very much.
Are we translating what Imam Muhammad Shahada stated? In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. Peace and blessings be upon all the prophets, from Moses, Jesus, to Prophet Muhammad. A special greeting to all the compassionate, understanding, and kind-hearted people attending today for the sake of peace and harmony. Peace and blessings be upon you all. To all the ones gathered here today, we all come here from the same roots, from the same father and mother, Adam and Eve, and we live in the same country regardless of difference of faith and race. We share everything that happens among us. As the quote states, life is meant to be shared. We need each other. He also stated a verse from the Holy Quran that states, O mankind, we have created you male and female and have made you nations and tribes so that you may know one another. The noblest of you in sight of God are the ones that are best in conducts and manners. So, O Allah, you are peace, and from you is peace, and to you is peace, so grant us all peace. The Prophet ﷺ said, the best among the believers are the ones that do not harm anyone with words or violence. Thank you very much.
Thank you both. Marwan Creedy.
I'd like to first take this opportunity to thank the mayor, thank Mayor-elect Kenny and the rest of the elected officials. Maria, thank you for coming, David O. And I'm not going to mention everybody, but thank you very much. Just want to make two quick points. One, the people who did this, right, the throwing the pig's head, they might have thought they were doing something against Daesh or ISIL. In fact, they're doing exactly what ISIL and the radicals want them to do. They want America to appear to be anti-Muslim. This will help them in their recruiting. This will help them in their propaganda. We can't let those extremists win. So whoever did this, you're playing into ISIL's playbook. Second, and I'm not going to get partisan political here, but I'm going to ask a personal plea from me to the Pennsylvania Republican Party. Please disinvite Donald Trump from your Pennsylvania Society event. I don't know if people know that, but Donald Trump, who has said these awful words about Americans, is a guest speaker at the Pennsylvania Society on Saturday, I believe. You cannot have him there. This is unacceptable. It's un-Pennsylvanian. It's un-American. So that's my personal plea. They have a lot more brighter people here who are going to speak, but my personal plea is on that. Thank you.
I want to thank you very much. I know that Rue Landau is here, one of our commissioners from the Philadelphia Commission on Human Relations, Brother Sadiq. I want to ask him to speak.
Thank you all for coming to this gathering here in our city in Philadelphia. I would like to just say on behalf of the Philadelphia Human Relations Commission in the city of Philadelphia is that these type of acts that took place down in Masjid Al-Aqsa, it's not something that we are in agreement with, and it's not something that we will be tolerating. And it's something that we have to really look into each other and see how acts like this bring us together. But in staying together, we have to remember that we have to come together and be proactive and not just always wait to be reactionary. Because being proactive prevents situations like this from escalating into things that could be detrimental for the whole of the society. So we just ask that we just look at roles that we can play as Philadelphians and as citizens of the United States of America of how we can be proactive and do those proactive acts. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brother Sadiq. I've asked Mayor-elect Kenny to come and say a few words.
Assalamu alaikum. Shalom alaikum. Peace be with you all. Each and every one of us Philadelphians and Americans should be outraged at what happened at Al-Aqsa. And not that long ago in this country, three Catholic churches were burned to the ground in Philadelphia. One, St. Michael's, right close to Al-Aqsa. This is reprehensible. This rhetoric is reprehensible. The coverage of the media of Donald Trump and his ridiculous nature and ridiculous words. Making him into some type of reality TV star again is ridiculous. Some of our own columnists who write about people and calling them illegal aliens by somehow dehumanizing them, they're not aliens, they're not Martians, they're human beings. And we desensitize, in many ways, the plight of people who have come here as immigrants because this country exists for them. It exists for the opportunity for people to come here and to have a better life. And once they get here, we are going to protect them, and we are not going to deal. We are not going to allow these folks who think that they can intimidate people in our city to be able to do this anymore. And we will stand with them. We will stand with them every time this happens until it stops. And I just apologize on behalf of all of us for what happened and what has happened in the past and some of the ugly incidents that have happened to our citizens. We are here. We have your back. We're not going anywhere. We've been through this before, and I think that people who have been here over a number of generations would understand that their history here was replete with a lot of this racism and prejudice. So thank you for being Philadelphians. Thank you for being here. We love you all.
Thank you very much.
Mayor Lakenny, thank you. Imam, thank you. Certainly, Marwan, thank you, and Brother Sadiq. Police Commissioner Ramsey, thank you for bringing the message with regard to the Philadelphia Police Department. I also want to thank all of our other faith leaders who are joined with us, and certainly many representatives of the political community. And again, I would make note of the fact that this gathering was called together not too long ago, and I am sure that there are many others who would have wanted to be here with us this afternoon. But the combination, from my perspective, and these are my thoughts and comments alone, the combination of last night and at least the reporting today of the comments by the Republican presidential candidate, that toxic combination was too much to go unresponded to. It is the height of insult, what someone did last night, and as Commissioner Ramsey indicated, we have an active investigation. We will, of course, at some point in time, find the coward, the person who lacked understanding and sensitivity and did what they did. But now I must turn to the comments of Mr. Trump. If nowhere else in the United States of America, Philadelphia and Pennsylvania must raise its collective voices. This is the place, the founding of the United States of America, the freedoms that we hold so dear, that all of us hold so dear, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. These are not just words on an historical document. The First Amendment that guarantees freedom of religion and the practice thereof in this country, again, emanates from William Penn through the Constitution to today. And it is still as true, it is still as right, it is still as forceful as it's ever been over the years. His comments, Donald Trump's comments, are a threat to the moral security of the United States of America. It engenders a level of fear fear-mongering that we have not seen literally since the 1930s and 40s. He's taken a page from the playbook of Hitler, demonize a group, blame that group for a country's problems, and then seek to ban or eliminate that group as some kind of solution to a problem that does not exist. This is, in fact, a very dangerous form of American radicalization. And my fear is that, as Mayor Al-Aqsa said, a reality TV person, a cartoon clown, is one thing. The concern here is that other Americans are actually paying attention to this insanity, that people are buying into this message, and that somehow his quote-unquote strength in the electorate continues to grow as he goes to the right of himself with more and more dangerous and insane comments. Donald Trump is literally trying to radicalize our fellow Americans against our American Muslim and international Muslim brothers and sisters. That's not what America is about. It's not what the electoral process is about. He is acting as a dangerous person right now. He and his message of hate have no place in Philadelphia, should have no place in Pennsylvania, and should be rejected by the majority of God-fearing, prayerful, faithful American citizens and many others around the world. Donald Trump has made himself a danger to our society and the freedoms that we enjoy by seeking to turn American against American, all for the sake of electoral points. He has crossed a moral line, and we, the people, need to stand on one side of that line and demonstrate our rejection of his rhetoric, which is damaging the psyche of the American public and puts all Americans at danger and risk in our own country and around the world. He does not understand the damage of his language, his rhetoric, and his antics. It needs to stop. Yes. Yes. You know, yeah, I understand that. I mean, if I had the power to ban some people, I mean, he would not, he would be at the top of the list today. But yesterday, there probably would have been some other folks. You know, I mean, we all kind of chuckle. I mean, again, that is our conflict here. We do believe in freedom of speech. But there are even restrictions on free speech. You cannot shout fire in a movie theater. There are a lot of things that you can or cannot say, even under our Constitution. But this is not a constitutional question. This is a moral question. This is a right and wrong question. These are questions that you learn the answer to when you're about 6 years old. Don't insult other people. Don't insult someone else's religion. The Muslim people, the true followers of faith, are peaceful people who take care of their families. They're not engaged in any of the terrorist kind of activities that we're seeing halfway around the world or across the other side of our country or even at times closer to home. And if he is not smart enough to figure out the difference, if he has no moral fiber left in his body, then he clearly is not qualified to lead the great United States of America. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I don't know how you do that. I mean, that's up to the Republican Party. What I would say is that, again, what the political leaders do and say is one thing. I'm concerned about my fellow Americans who are following this nonsense, this rhetoric, this insanity, based on fear, a lack of understanding of the true religion, and have confused themselves by following a madman like him. So I don't know what the Republican Party is going to do. That's their problem. I'm a Democrat. We have our own challenges. Nothing of that sort. So they need to figure out what they're going to do with him.
You don't think the comparison to Hitler is unfair?
No. It's the same tactic and strategy. Find an enemy, convince people they're the enemy, blame every problem on them, and then try to get rid of them. This has happened before. With any number of folks in this room here today at different points in time, almost every race, and often religion, is used as a weapon to divide people and to separate them out. And that's what he is doing. I think more leaders need to speak out. Other cities, states across the United States of America. It appears even that some high-ranking Republican leaders have come to the conclusion that enough is enough, or it's too much, or whatever the case may be. I don't know how you all deal with this. And I think, again, the mayor made reference to it, and I have my own views on it. I mean, at some point in time, you all have to decide who you're going to cover, how you're going to cover them, how much airtime they get, and do you want that crap going out over your airwaves? That's your decision, not you personally. That's a media decision. Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry, dear. Well, first of all, when he said what he said about the Mexican-American community, I spoke out on that particular issue. It was around the time that I was actually in Mexico. And so during that visit in Mexico City and in Puebla, I made reference to his then ignorant comments with regard to Mexican Americans. I think characterizing members of the Mexican community as I'm actually not going to say what he said. But we all know what it was. And there were any number of comments, supportive comments made by, I'm sure, some folks up here. What we're finding is that no group is safe from his ignorance and rhetoric as he increasingly tries to target a message narrowly crafted, politically driven, and devised to speak to a very narrow cast audience for his own purposes that have nothing to do, in my view, with actually trying to be president of the most powerful nation on the planet. Yes?
Has anyone reached out to the folks at Pennsylvania GOP regarding Mr. Trump's appearance at the Pennsylvania Society? And if so, what kind of response have you got from?
Well, that's actually the first I've heard that he's actually appearing at the PA Society. I had heard earlier today about an appearance at a fundraiser for some other Pennsylvania candidate. I did not hear of an actual appearance at PA Society, which will cause me to have to adjust my schedule.
That's what the latest I heard.
Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. No, he's way beyond. Way beyond. I think that, you could find a situation where, should he appear, any number of good-hearted people would just get up and walk out. mean, there's no way in the world I'm going to sit in a room with that idiot. Yeah. Last question. What does that have to do with the Muslim community?
Well, he feels that we're at war with
him. He's an asshole. I mean, I apologize, Reverends. People in the religious community, I apologize. How can I take seriously any foreign policy idea from someone like him? I mean, it's impossible. So he has no idea what he's talking about. I apologize. I'm very, very sorry. Truly sorry. Last question before I get myself in more trouble.
I appreciate your honesty. It's very
appreciated. Okay. Thank you all very much. Let us continue to carry a message of peace and love for our Muslim brothers and sisters. God bless. Sheikh, I'm sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know. Hey, I'm sorry. My fault. We're not done. I'm sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Friends, we are going to end this conference with a statement from the Religious Leaders Council of Greater Philadelphia and the Interfaith Center of Greater Philadelphia as well. At Al-Aqsa Islamic Society and School, our founding and active partners in both the Interfaith Center of Greater Philadelphia and the Religious Leaders Council of Greater Philadelphia, today we stand with Imam Muhammad Shahada and our friends in that community, saddened that they have been victims of a vile act of desecration targeting a sacred place of worship and study. We have known the great beauty, peace, love, and strength that comes from our work together as diverse faith communities. Together we weave bonds that cannot be broken. Together we demonstrate that religion can be a force for good. And together we continue to affirm publicly our commitment to dare to understand one another. We rededicate ourselves to the work of dialogue, education, and community building that seems more urgent each day. We stand united by the following commitment and invite the citizens of our region to join us. These are the words spoken by communities in zones of peace. We dedicate ourselves as individuals to promote peace in our homes and communities. To promote peace, join me, in our homes and communities. We pledge to work with others to eliminate the causes of hatred. To eliminate the causes of hatred, to honor the dignity of all people, to honor the dignity of all people, to dare to understand, to dare to understand. We pledge to be instruments of God's peace, to make our homes and neighborhoods zones of peace, free from fear. To make our homes and neighborhoods zones of peace, free from fear, filled with respect, and marked with deeds of kindness. Thank you very much.
I'm sorry. I need to give you an actual complete answer. Ask me the question again, please. First of all, we heard from President Obama just Sunday night, and if Mr. Trump listened, he would know a little more. Secondly, we are not at war with Muslims. We are not at war with Islam. We are at war with terrorists, often referred to as ISIS or ISIL or others, groups and organizations, Al-Qaeda, whomever, who mean harm to Americans and other people of free will. That's who we're at war with. We are not at war with the Muslim community. We are not at war with Islam, the religion. We are at war with people who mean us harm. There is a difference. He needs to understand that. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
John Barrett. Yeah, I don't know.
Just so.
I don't know.
Thank you for coming.
Philadelphia, he is speaking at
it. At the dinner? The Commonwealth lunch. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.